Hi all, subscribe to our channel on YouTube and click on the bell icon to get the latest updates. For course inquiries, visit our website www.gatelectures.com and don't forget to register and subscribe to the latest post section.
So in the last video, we discussed about the symbol flow control methods. And at the ending of the video, I have given you a formula to find what is the efficiency of simple flow control method. Now, using this efficiency, we can find out a lot of things. And one of those things is the throughput of the network. And what does exactly mean when I'm saying throughput of the network is what is the effective work that you are doing. See, efficiency is something you measure about what is the efficient time that you have utilized. Let us say, if you worked on something for 10 hours, but out of 10 hours, you only got a work which worth of 6 hours only. So therefore, your efficiency is 6 divided by 10. That means you have only 60% efficiency. But with you can find effectively how much work you have done, or work done. In the same way here, if you find out what is the efficiency, then you can find out what is the effective bandwidth. Effective bandwidth. And what does this effective bandwidth mean? Effective bandwidth mean, let us say you have a 100 Mbps connection at your home and you're using simple flow control methods. Now, because of this 100 Mbps connection, what is the effective speed that you are getting because you are using simple flow control methods, right? So effective bandwidth is generally bandwidth, whatever the bandwidth you have, multiplied by the efficiency. Whatever the bandwidth you have multiplied by the efficiency. So it can also be written as bandwidth multiplied by TT upon TT plus 2 into TP. TT plus 2 into TP. And this effective bandwidth is also called as throughput. Throughput and effective bandwidth both are the same terminologies. Therefore, if you make or if you play with this formula, you can find out a lot of things. That bandwidth multiplied by TT. TT is transmission time. So transmission time is also called as length of data packet upon bandwidth divided by TT plus 2 into TP. TT plus 2 into TP. So you can cancel out this bandwidth with this bandwidth. So it will be length of data packet upon TT plus 2 into TP. That is again one more formula to find the throughput of the network. Okay. Now here we have TT plus 2 into TP. Again, you can open these formulas and you can find out a lot of things. Like this is TT, so it can be length of data packet upon length upon bandwidth plus 2 into TP. Okay. So we can, it is not at all useful for us. Okay. So you can say that throughput of the network, just by seeing this, throughput of the network or effective bandwidth is inversely proportional. Throughput or effective bandwidth is inversely proportional to the propagation delay. Because here again you can see throughput here, bandwidth here, transmission time here, and in denominator we have 2 into TP. Therefore throughput of the network is inversely proportional to the propagation delay. Propagation delay means if your propagation delay is more, then throughput is less. If propagation delay is less, then throughput is more. Or because if the propagation delay is more, then throughput is less. That means if these two hosts are staying at very far locations, maybe this is in India and second host is in USA. Now, because they are staying at very far location, therefore you are going to get very low efficiency. But if, let us say, one computer is in your one room, room one, within the same house, and second computer is in room two or within the same house, then because the distance is very small, therefore you are going to get very high throughput. And this kind of network where the distance is very small, this is called as a LAN or local area network. Hence we can say simple flow control methods are very good for LANs. They are very good for LANs. Okay, or you can say very small networks. Secondly, now because this throughput is directly proportional to the length of the data packet. directly proportional to the length of the data packet. You can find it out easily, right? Because of here, from here also you can find out length of data packet, and from here also, if you again solve this equation, you can also find out that it is directly proportional to the length of the data packet. Now, because it is directly proportional to the length of the data packet, that means if the length of the data packet that you are sending, that is very large, if you are sending very large chunks of data, then your effective bandwidth or throughput of the network will increase. Throughput of the network will go up or it will increase. Okay, so then analyze based on these values. Hence, simple flow control methods are good for LANs. In a case when you are sending the data packets whose size are very, the size of the data packet is very, very high. Okay. Now, based on these values, we are also going to solve some of the questions which are asked in previously for GATE as well as for UGC NET examinations. See, all these examinations are interrelated. So, GATE, we have 12 subjects. In UGC NET, we have 18 subjects. All these 12 subjects which are present in GATE, they are also present in UGC NET. So, as a GATE student, you should practice as much problems as possible. You should practice problems from UGC NET. You should practice problems from ISRO, DRDO, and all these examinations. Or as a UGC NET student, it is important for you to practice for questions from GATE also. Okay, that is why these two subjects are very, very interrelated to each other. Fine. So in the next video, we'll start with the simple discussions with the previous year questions. We'll take some questions from these different examinations. We'll discuss in the videos. Okay.